And welcome to the first episode of Ask the Expert series on Power Conversion Systems. My name is Vivek Singh, and I'm the head of the business unit PCS at Trumpf Uerdinger. During this series, I and my colleagues would like to focus on some of the challenges faced by the battery manufacturers or system integrators of these energy storage systems when they are shopping for the right power electronics, and hopefully show you some ways how to cope with these challenges. In today's session, we would like to specially focus on the challenges faced by the flow battery manufacturers when they are shopping for the right power electronics. Now, the first concern that the flow battery manufacturers have is what is the right optimum stack. Now, a typical nominal cell voltage range of a flow battery can be anywhere between 1 to 2.43 volts based on the kind of flow battery that you use. And then these cells are stacked together to reach higher voltages so that they can then operate in conjunction with a suitable inverter. Now, most likely, the battery manufacturers will have a sweet spot, a right spot, which defines the number of stacks based on the cell chemistry or the design. And not necessarily, this particular voltage would meet the specifications of the inverter that you may have chosen. Another tricky part that the flow battery manufacturers face is the electrolyte formation prior to the normal operation of a flow battery cell. While a normal operational voltage range of a flow battery could be anywhere between 35 to 75 volts, sometimes even higher, the electrolyte formation happens at 0 volts. This means that we require DC current sources that can operate at these low voltages. And this can sometimes force the flow battery manufacturers or the designers to go for a completely separate unit for this electrolyte formation before switching over to the storage inverter. Now, if you have seen any or maybe both of these problems during your design process, then perhaps we might have a solution for you. The modular design of the TrueConvert series addresses both these problems and then some more. Let's take a look. What we have here is the DC-DC converter. Then you have the system control, the brains, and then you have the AC-DC inverter. Focusing today on the DC-DC converter because that is what will resolve these problems. The low voltage module of this DC-DC converter is galvanically isolated from the high voltage module, so you get your safety for free. The low voltage module is able to cover the entire voltage range from 0 to 75 volts. That means you do not need a separate unit for the electrolyte formation. The high voltage module then boosts this voltage till it reaches the acceptable voltage range of the inverter, which is about 850 volts. Now, this could be either the inverter that we have, or the system is capable of connecting with a third-party inverter as well. Oh, and by the way, the DC-DC converter is a silicon carbide design, just in case you wanted to know how future-proof the technology is. Now, these were just two of the many advantages that the TrueConvert series has to offer. We would be happy to discuss more details if you have further interest in using the TrueConvert series. In the next video, we would focus on the off-grid features of the TrueConvert series. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.